In your election news headlines this hour, the ANC says it will be appealing the Durban High Court's ruling that dismissed its bid with costs for interdictory relief over the use of the Umkhonto weSizwe name and logo.
There's been a significant weaponization of loadshedding. So some of them have used this as part of a campaign tool.
On the power front, Electricity Minister Dr. Hosienzo Ramakgopa has dismissed reports of load shedding being used as an electioneering tool, urging the public to avoid the noise and to look towards further reduction in the intensity of rolling blackouts.
This area is surrounded by industry. You have the refinery, you have factories. When was this in the next? It's in the middle of industries.
Also, the Patriotic Alliance leader, Gayton McKenzie, has called for improved cooperation between the private sector and government to address unemployment in the community of Wentworth. This is south of Durban. Sinibingelele sinamukele ohlelweni lenu elithandayo futhi nelikhonze kakhulu i-Elections 360 Daily, lapho sobe sikhuluma khona ngey'hloko ezihlukahlukene ezibalulekile futhi ke mbukeli njengoba sibheke okhethweni. Kanti-ke igama ngumxolisi wakwamasango. So kulo hlelo ke mbukeli, we will be criss-crossing eMzantsi Africa, the lengths and depths of the country, giving you wena i-microphone to give us your views on different election subject matters. This happens ke every Monday to Thursday from 5 to 5:30 p.m. Khonela kunqaphambili SABC 1 eMzansi for sure kanye na ku DTT, including all of our digital platforms. Namhlanje ke ohlelweni we are discussing the issue of hijacked and abandoned buildings causing distress emiphakathini across eMzansi Africa. Kuthiwa ke mbukeli lamabhilidi ayasha bese ke abantu basale bedengwane. Futhi ke kwesinye isikhathi kwenzeka nezinto zokuthi abantu balahle nama documents afana nama IDs kanye nama certificates abo. Abanye ke usetshenziswa ke ugesi namanzi ngokungemthetho. Abanye ke kuthiwa ke nobugebengu ubhidlangile kulamabhilidi. So what are your views on this particular subject matter? Esiyidingedayo namhlanje ohlelweni ungaxhumana nathi ey'nkundleni zethu zokuxhumana. Be a part of this conversation. Ungashayela kucingo 011-714-0726 noma ku-0727 okanye ku-0728. You can also hit us up on our social media platforms ku-X khona as SABC Izindaba kanye naku-Facebook as the same SABC Izindaba. Khumbula-ke ukuthi usebenzise i-hashtag yethu ethi #elections360daily. This makes it easy for us to pick up all your interaction. Kanti-ke Elections 360 Daily mbukeli iqala njengamanje. Kanti-ke namhlanje samukele ivakashi zethu that join us for le nkulumo. Kanti-ke namhlanje sihambisana from the Socio-Economic Rights Institute of South Africa u-Edward Molopi kanye no from abahlali basemjondolo i-spokesperson sakhona uThuso Mohapi. Gentlemen, nginibingelele nginamukele ohlelweni. It's great to have you. I'm looking forward to our engagement.
Siyabonga.
All right, ngaphambi kwalokho ithi-ke siqale lana-ke mbukeli. Kuthiwa-ke safety hazards, urban decay and socio-economic challenges, illegal activities are just some of the results of the troubling issue of hijacked and abandoned buildings in the inner cities across eMzantsi Africa. Kuthiwa ke njengoba sesiyokhethweni, the election season in particular, it's crucial to address lo daba lolu. And what needs to be done to address this issue, which is highly linked to access to izindlu for abantu. So what is the impact of the economic hubs? Is there political will to fix this issue? Ngizokutshela-ke njengamanje mbukeli ukuthi-ke insert lelandelayo will inform us just how serious this matter is.
In cities across South Africa, from Johannesburg to Cape Town, the site of dilapidated buildings stands as a stark reminder of urban decay. Many of these structures have been hijacked or abandoned, left to deteriorate over time. Some buildings in Johannesburg, like this one, have been scorched, leaving residents destitute.
Impilo ibenzima ngoba okwenzekile bese kumele siphile impilo entsha, siqale a new life. So immediately kushile la umasipala usithathile wasibeka kwenye indawo ematendeni. So nje kube nzima nokuhlala khona ngoba okokuqala nje ukudla akukho, kumele uphume mase kulate kunobugebenga estradini. So sineyinkinga nje ezinjalo kakhulu.
These buildings often become magnets for crime, serving as hideouts for drug dealers, thieves, and squatters. But perhaps most alarming is the fact that they exacerbate the country's housing crisis as thousands of people desperately need shelter.
So kuna abantu abahlala ngaphakathi abanye ufica kunemikhukhu ngaphakathi kuna abantu abahlala kunobugebunge obuningi ke kwindawo enzalo because of kungena akunama security kungena nabangubani sokwenziwa noma yini. So I think mabe ngazama ukuthi kube khona something yokushintsha nokuthi ba-check-e kakuhle kube khona kubhekisise kakuhle kuhlolwe kakuhle ngendlela ezi-right yokuba kujonge uba ziindawo ezilungileyo na okokuba zingahlala abantu. Kunga singalwi kube khona ngathi sifast okanye mhlawumbe sifuna ujonge uba kwenzeka ntoni ekuhlaleni mase kuzawuvotwa kuthiwe mase kuye kuvotwa kube khaneke ngoku sesifuna ungaze ukuthi khane sifuna ukuqondisisa imisebenzi yokuthi abantu ba-right na.
We at Elections 360 Daily reached out to some of the country's political parties to shed light on this plight and to also let us in on what they plan to do with this issue if elected into power on May 29th.
It's a matter that really needs government to attend to it, but obviously it's a matter that also needs the involvement of the private sector to come in and being able to operate there. But the private sector will tell you, Lebo, that they will not be able to operate in an environment of chaos. They need a government to be able to exercise its authority in terms of bylaw enforcement, in terms of urban management, in terms of waste removal, and in terms of arresting criminals without fail, you know, and dealing with the criminality that happens on each and every corner of the city. So it's government in the main that needs to come in and do the right thing.
What we are saying as the African Independent Congress, we need to promote the ownership on the rental stock. Once you have rented on the rental stock of government for more than, say, minimum 5 years, maximum 10 years, then the government must be able to say, we are giving you the title deed. So we will advocate the ownership of the rental stock so that people must own. Once people own their place of settlement, there will be less vulnerability into the issues of hijacked buildings. And we will minimize the risk.
The issue of hijacked and abandoned buildings remains a complex challenge requiring collaboration between government, communities and political stakeholders to find sustainable solutions.
Sibonge kakhulu kuproducer wethu uLebo for lowo mbiko. And Mr. Molopi, asiqale ngawe just to give us a bit of context and perspective ngalo daba esikhuluma ngalo namhlanje. Kuthiwa iphenomenon leyo yokubona abantu aba-operator lama building lena akusiyinto esiqala ukuyibona njengamanje. And we do know ukuthi akhona ama-contributing factors such as ukubona kokufuduka kwabantu from one place to another for amathuba angqono wemisebenzi namathuba angqono wokwenza imali. But perhaps just give us an overview ngokuthi what are some of the contributing factors as Joba Sbona, linkinga esibhekane nayo njengamanje.
Yes, no, thank you, coach. Now, the issue lay esibhekane nayo, there are a couple of things that contribute, as you state. But amongst them is one, the issue of ukuthi people need housing. And unfortunately, the people that are in the inner city, if you're looking at the statistics, Stats SA released Amas stats just recently, and they will tell you, ukuthi, the people who are living in the inner city, in terms of their income level and income ability, unable to afford a local okufunwa market. So if you go and try and rent in the market, you'll find that you are unable because of the low wages that people get and the high unemployment rates that we see. So firstly is an issue of access to adequate housing that's there. So which then leads ukuthi abantu have to look in the informal economy to find housing for them to stay in. Yeah. And unfortunately, that informal economy that exists currently is largely in these buildings that we are speaking about.
Yeah, today. And this is why I also want us to bring in Mr. Mohapi, because ngiyazi ukuthi ama values amanye nisebenza ngawo nibahlali basemjondolo, nikhuluma ngomhlaba, nikhuluma ngezindlu, nikhuluma ngesithunzi sabantu as well. Talk to us about how konke lokhu and assisting abantu that are now kulezimo lezi ezifana nalezi kulama buildings lawa integrates or works with emission yenu as abahlali basemjondolo, because if I can rewind to some engagements that I've had and inhlangano yenu to a certain extent, nasho ukuthi you are looking out for the marginalized.
Kunjalo, kunjalo mxolisi. Abahlali babakhelwe khona lokuvikela isithunzi sabantu abampofu abanganakiwe. So uma ngabe kwenzeka izinto enjena khona kuye kusiphathe kabe ukuthi ugovernment wabantu engakwazi kanjani ukuphatha abantu ngendlela kanje. Of course le issue yala ma building yona i very serious and issue ekufanele iphathwe ngendlela enesithunzi ukuze abantu, ngoba sikhuluma ngabantu la, asikhulumi nje ngabantu abangenaso isithunzi and abangafanele benganawo amalungelo.
And ikuphi inkinga babo Happy, ngoba ngiyakuza ukukhuluma ngohulumende. Do you think uhulumende that's the problem njengamanje?
Kunjalo msakazi, ngoba mesikhuluma siyibhekisa kuhulumeni, uyena umuntu oyikhanda obhekelele izwe. So mengabe amathuba bengawenzi izinto zama-economic endaweni zasemakhaya, of course abantu bazofudukela emadolobheni amakhulu bezobheka iy'mpilo ey'ngcono. Ekubhekeni kwabo iy'mpilo ey'ngcono, siyazi la imisebenzi esiyitholayo, imisebenzi efika, imali ifika esandleni siyaphela njalo. So lokho kubenza abantu bagcine bebheka iy'ndawo ezishibhile zokuthi barente ukuze bahlale. So mengabe kwayena uhulumeni engakwaza, uhulumeni une backlog of 300,000 ezindlu afanele ezakhiwe. So lokho kwenza izinto zibe nzima ekubantwini mebesuka emakhaya bezobheka amathuba emsebenzi, bezobheka ukufunda iy'kole ezingcono ukuthi bafunde kuzona ezempilo ezingcono, ngoba lezi zinto azikho emakhaya.
So qhubeka-ke nale nkulumo ethi ke siyothengisa. Mbukela usahlezi nathi khona la kwi-Elections 360 Daily. Siyabuye emva kwalokho. Bukeli siyaqhubeka-ke ngodaba esikhuluma ngalo namhlanje ohlelweni mayelana ney'nselele as a result of hijacked and abandoned buildings with our guests ohlelweni. Kodwa here's what people have had to say about these challenges emgwaqweni.
Ukufisa kwami nje ukufisa ukuthi i-government yethu izame ukuthi iqinisele indawo zokuhlala njengalapha nje. Bengathelekile lapha kwenza ubugebengu, ngicela ukuthi benqande ubugebengu, kube ney'ndawo zokuhlala ezi-right for abantu njengoba besusiwe la abanye abahlala begangeni.
Into esicela ukuthi asize ngawo government, kunabantu abahlupheke kakhulu abadinga izindlu, kanye nala esihlala khona akukho right, izindlu zakhona zikho right, amanzi asiwatholi.
La ematendini sasokola. Kuyanetha, kuyabanda, mina nje mina angisalali kahle kahle, sengilalela le phezulu etawuni, ngibuye sengizoyilalela ekuseni emini cause nasebusuku kuyathusa, kunaqhuma nebhamu lana.
Mbukela uhlelo lakho-ke lele and your say matters. Kungakho manje sithatha u-anonymous that joins us on the line. Sikubingelela sikwamukele ku-Elections 360 Daily. Sawubona anonymous, sawubona.
Hello.
Kunjani?
Ngiyaphila njani?
Hayi, siyaphila nathi. Uthini umbono wakho namhlanje ohlelweni?
With regards to Izindaba, yama buildings are abandoned. I just feel like they have become a breeding ground for ama criminals and vagrants. But beyond that, it's a safety issue as well. We've seen a number of situations where these abandoned buildings have burnt down and a number of people have been hurt. So I definitely think this is something to look into and something to in order to vigela abantu that are out there in the public.
Enevela anona masigabona nami ukuthi kubalekile ukuthi abantu bavikeleke kodwa ke njengoba sesibona nabantu bangana indawo zokuhlala ithi ke sizwe ukuthi wena ngabe emphakathini wakho kunjani as we having this conversation njengamanje ama challenges enhlangano bezana nawo as far as indawo zokuhlala are concerned.
Yeah, I understand that yona indaba yokuthi indawo zokuhlala azikho, but at the same time I think it goes beyond that. It's a safety issue, and I think the government needs to jump in to ensure that these people have the necessary places that they need to stay in. Because at the end of the day, the situation here, if a building is abandoned, I see something that are safe for people to live. Therefore, government needs to step in to ensure that abantu are living in dignified situations. I got you.
Okay, Anonymous, sibonge kakhulu ngombono wakho. Anonymous, lawyer on the line. And I think kukhona ama-takeouts engiwatholayo from u-Anonymous njengamanje. But Mr. Molopi, sizwe kuwe ukuthi ngabe i-occupation yalamabhilide iba nomthelela onjani, phecelezi an effect on these communities, these immediate surrounding communities?
Yeah, I mean, I think the first thing is that we need to acknowledge ukuthi within these buildings, kuhlalabantu, who are raising their families. You have mothers in there with their children, and now they want to feel safe. And so the security, in as much as it concerns us as abantu who are walking the streets of Joburg, it also concerns them who live in these buildings. And so when we speak about the issue, Guti, there needs to be access control, and there needs to be issues of security. These are things that when we speak to the residents, they are also raising ukuthi nathi sifuna ukuphepha kule ndawo esihlala kuzo, and we are not finding support in terms of that. And so sometimes you'll find that they organize themselves as residents to say, how do we try and make the place that we live in safer for us, and so they will and they will look at measures that they can do now internally to ensure ukuthi there is security on the ground. But yeah, I mean, I think it's a fact ukuthi people are not feeling safe walking around Johannesburg, and I just wanted to bring the acknowledgement ukuthi even the people who live in these buildings are also victims of the same crimes that we are crying about. And so the solution that we need to look into is one that's going to be ezobhekana nathi sonke, and not just thinking ukuthi everybody who lives in those buildings is,
as if it's a one shoe size
is a criminal onkumuntu ohlala lapha naye is party to the criminal activities that take place.
And Mr. Mohapi, njengoba sinale nkulumo siyabona nama visuals la avelayo njengamanje of that building eyala eGoli that also burnt down, wasweleka abantu, abantu have been given temporary housing. Just how sustainable is this solution njengamanje for labantu?
Ayikho sustainable ngoba recently nje sizwile kuthiwa kungathi khona sebedeportiwe, and uminister akekho aware ngalokho yena. If we had temporary housing, iba inkinga ngoba ugovernment uvela aqhamuke ezo imposer izinto kubantu ngaphandle kokuthi alalela abantu ukuthi bona bacabangani ngokuthi njoba sekunesimo ekunenhlekelele nje nevelile, ngicabanga ukuthi sinibeke kanjani ukuze nabantu bebe nombono abawubekayo ekubekeni kwabo lowo mbono ukuze bezizwe nabo bebalulekile emva kwaleya nhlekelele. Kodwa uma uthi uyabuka isimo sabo from kulesi simade bekusona kulesi simo abakusona kuwes kakhulu kunalokho ade bekubona, and akekho umuntu onendaba nabo ngoba manje sekuyinkinga yabo bodwa njengoba sebethathwe babekwe eceleni. Ugovernment ngapha usekwabantu angabanakile, okuyinto embike ngoba sikhuluma ngemiphefumulo lana, sikhuluma ngabantu abaphilayo abafana nami nawe. So kuyakhathaza khona indlela abantu abatrithwa ngayo, akukhathali-ke noma ngaze kuthiwa uqhamuka kweliphizwe. Uma umuntu wakhiwe ngesiqu somuntu, kufanele unikezwe ilungelo lakho, uhlonishwe njengomuntu, unikezwe futhi isithunzi njengomuntu ukuthi uhleze ilungelo lakho lihloniphekile, ngabe ukephi noma uhlalaphi.
Kodwa ke uma sesibuka ke futhi njobe ukhuluma kanjalo ikhona ngabe hlabeni indlela bakwazi uqinisekisa ukuthi abantu laba ba occupiers zona le ndawo bakhona ngendlela efanele, first of all legally, because siya sezwa nemibiko yokuthi sekuyabangiswana kunomdonsiswano ukuthi ke abanye akumelanga babe ngabe bahlele khona ngoba abanawo amaphepha ukuthi babe la eMzansi Afrika.
Mhlawumbe ixolisi ukuqala izwe linomthetho. And njoba kwaba khona amaborder, inkinga yokuqala fanele ilungiswe emaborder. Ngoba ngaba sikhulumi ngale issue ukuba amaborder kunomthetho and amaborder aqinile. Njoba kwaba khona siyakwamukela lo ukuthi of course abantu siya sithi Africa akho amaborder. Kodwa siyakwamukela ngoba kwabekwa imithetho ukuthi kube namaborder. So ayiqineke imithetho phela kuze abantu bengangeni ngokungekho emthethweni ezweni.
Yeah.
Ngoba kuzokuzovimba leyo nto ukuthi kungadaleki lezi inkinga esiyibonayo.
At guess yothengisa ke and kuwudaba that we also touched on ohlelweni. I think kuleviki eliphelile. Mbukeli siyabuya emva kwalokhu sahlezi nathi khona la kwi-Elections 360 Daily. Usahlezi nathi khona la ku-Elections 360 Daily. Khumbula ke mbukela ukuthi uhlelo lwakho lolo and your say always matters ngaso sonke isikhathi. Namhlanje ke sibuzeke nake isombululo to the pressing issue of hijacked and abandoned buildings eMzansi Afrika. Ethi ke sizwe ukuthi nina ngabe nitheni inkundleni zethu zokuxhumana. So uDumisani uthi azilungiswe kufake abafundi. Well, that would be another solution with Dumisani. Uphendu uthi mazilungiswe kuhlaliswe kuzo abantwana abasema university. Bahlale mahala, bafumane imfundo mahala. From Uphendu, Isaac says abomasipala kwamele ziwele ngaphansi kwabo lezo zakhiwe, baziqashise kanjalo, bangenza inzuzo. Ithwasa lithi azilungiswe izakhiwo zihlale abantu abasebenza emadolobheni siyafa ama rent. And I think also this is another point because gentlemen, we've got just 30 seconds ukuthi siyirephe le nkulumo yethu around ama solutions. Perhaps let's start with you njengamanje ukuthi sconsolidate konke lokhu in so far as bringing government in as well.
Yeah, I mean I think one of your viewers stated ukuthi issues around affordable rental ukuthi a lot of the issues that we are facing is because there isn't affordable rental in the inner city. And so if they can look into making it affordable for the people who are currently living in the inner city, they would help.
I'm so sorry. Just a quick one, Mr. Mohabi.
No, sibonga mqhele. Khona kubalekile ukuthi uhulumeni azilungise lamabhilidi la ukuze abantu abazofuna amathuba emsebenzi emadolobheni anjengalawa bakwazi ukukhokha irent futhi irent ezokwazi ukuthi ba-afford.
Okay. All right, Edward Molopi, and of course, sibongeka kakhulu ke na kuthuso Mohabi as well for joining us namhlanje ohlelweni. Thank you so much for your time, gentlemen. I wish we had time. Sibeka la yena namhlanje ke mbukeli. Thank you so much for joining us. Kuze kube ngokuzayo nisale kahle.